In this tutorial, we're going to go through featured images and thumbnails in your Elegant Themes. Elegant Themes uses two ways that you can have images show up on your page. Firstly, we'll look at a page without an image. All your blog posts are usually set up by default to have a thumbnail image, and we've gone through that separately in a separate video. Pages are not normally set up with a thumbnail image by default, so that's the first thing we need to correct. So first thing we do is go to Appearance and down to our Theme Options, and we click on in our ePanel Layout Settings, and then click on Single Page Layout tab. And here you can see Place Thumbnails on Page. Here is where we need to click to enable this feature on your pages, because this is not set up by default on pages, only on posts. Also, while you're here, you could also enable comments if you wish them to be set up on pages as well. By default, this is disabled. Then click Save. Now we go back to Pages, and we click on our page that we've either created or editing. And the first way you can get that image to appear on your page is to go down here to the featured image section in the right hand column. Click on set featured image, and then you can either load your files directly from your computer or click on the media library and search for the photo that you'd like. Click show. And then you'll see here in these options, it says use as featured image. That's what you want to click. And then just close the box, and you can see now that your featured image is put here. If you click update, and now we'll go and have a look at that page again and refresh that. You can see here now that image has been placed in this stylized frame. That's what we call the thumbnail, and your text and other images appear alongside it. The other option you can do is if we remove this featured image, you can also have a thumbnail that appears here. Under the custom fields box, you'll have an option for thumbnails, either a drop-down menu with thumbnail already appearing, or if it's not already there, you can click Enter New and then type Thumbnail with a capital T and click on Add Custom Field. Then you just paste in the URL of your image from your media library. So you just need to go into your media library and copy the URL of the image you'd like. So if we just go there now, we go to your media library, we'll just find that same image there, and if we click on edit, you'll see the file URL is just at the bottom here. So we just highlight that and copy, go back to our page, and then we're going to change that image there, and you just need to click update. Remember to click update or the changes won't happen, and then click update for your whole page. This is the update button here, so click update. And now if we go to chameleon, if we go to the about us page again, we can see that that's kept that image there, just to show you how easily that can change. If we go back to our media library, and I'm going to change it to a different image, so I'm going to click on that image, go to the file URL and copy, go back to my page, change the URL here to the new image, click update for the custom field, and then click update for the whole page. Now we'll just check our page, and you can see here now that's changed that image there for the page. So there's two areas where you can set an image to appear. That's a featured image, or under custom fields as your thumbnail and the value, the URL here. And that's how you change images for pages.